October, the first game, the first Devils goal, Christophe Oliva in Atlanta. The halfway mark was reached Thursday in Buffalo, the 125th Devils goal into an empty net from Scott Gomez. Co-leaders of the East, the Devils have seen long goals by first-year players and impressive plays from the balanced scoring lines, winning games in overtime. But the hallmark of Devils hockey has been prevention of goals, the blanking of big stars. If the defense doesn't do it, the goaltender does. Tonight, the Devils start the second half of the season against the Phoenix Coyotes at the Meadowlands on PAX 31.
To the Continental Airlines Arena. Tonight they take on the Phoenix Coyotes, the first home game of the new year. A large crowd expected tonight at the Continental Airlines Arena as the Devils look to run their unbeaten streak now to 8 straight games. Hello again, everyone. I'm Matt Laughlin. Welcome to Devils hockey here on PAX 31. What a road trip it was for New Jersey. Beginning on New Year's Day against Boston, they go unbeaten, winning their last 3. And as I mentioned, their unbeaten streak now at a season high 7 games. So the Devils are starting to hit on all cylinders, and they've moved up in the Eastern Conference. For more on that and tonight's game, upstairs we send you to Doc Emmerich and Chico Resch.
Thank you, Matt, very much. Good evening, everyone. The Devils' first half has been tremendous, and let's take a look at some numbers to compare it to the second half, or rather the first half of last year, and project into the second half. Here we go. Points percentage, 659 over 622. Tremendous. Higher in the standings. More goals scored. Fewer goals yielded. Power play, a little less than at this time last year. Penalty killing, 89%. You project the second half of the season, if they keep going like this, it may very well be the best season that the Devils have had in their history. Part of the thing that is always said about the Devils is they're so defensively oriented, they don't score goals. They scare goals easily. Wrong. Take a look at these numbers and you will find that they are among the best shooting teams in the Eastern Conference. The Penguins, Panthers, and Flyers are averaging over 3 goals per game. The Devils are 3.01 and 4th in the conference, and that is the scary part.
You're right, Michael, and you know, no matter how well you play defensively, there comes a time where you have to score a goal or two, or if you can get up into the 3-4 average, that's very impressive. That's Bobby Holík ripping one against the Penguins, and here is Peter Sykora, who's been razor sharp and hot as well. Terrific balance also within that scoring of 3.01 goals per game.
Yeah, and they're keeping out 2.41, and that's 4th best in the conference, like their goals scored. And they do a great job at defense.
Well, they really do, Mike. And again, you know, what I like about the Devils is the balanced scoring and repelling goals. There you see Kenny Danico going down, blocking a shot. Here was the other night in Pittsburgh. Remember Jágr? We showed you a bunch of times of how he was surrounded, how aggressively he was played. That time it was Stevens and Madden. But Mike, you don't want to be topside on one side or the other. You don't want to just be all offense or all defense. Right now, Devils seem to have that perfect balance.
But they are missing something on defense tonight. Scott Stevens is ill, will not be able to play. Brad Bombardier will be matched up with Brian Rafalski. Let's look at the standings. First, the Eastern Conference, where the Devils hold 4th, and they are knotted with Toronto for first place. The only 2 idle teams are number 7 Carolina and number 12 Montreal. Toronto already leading the Rangers tonight. Phoenix plays in the West. How do they stand? Pretty darn good. They are ranked 2nd seed overall, leading their division with 48 points. So it's a good year for the Phoenix Coyotes so far. They